600 feet, and you already have the stock, or have in stock. All right, fencing, you got in stock. So I've got 400 feet of fence, and I want to, I feel like I've done this problem with you guys before. Did I do this problem with you guys before? All right, whatever. I can do it again. All right, so my mom wants me to build a garden. And so she gets me that, you know, like that diamond fencing that they have. And she's got 400 feet of the stuff. And she wants me to build her a fence around the garden that I'm working on for her. So I put it inside of a rectangle. And I know that the thing it wants to be a rectangle. So she wants a rectangle distance X on this side. All right? Let's see. If one side of the enclosure is labeled X, what are the units in feet? Where the units of X in feet? Which should be the base of the labeled term X? Okay, so there's one thing I know. I know that if I add up X plus whatever this is, let's make it a question mark for now, plus X would be over here, plus another question mark. So what is that? Two question marks plus two X's is equal to what? Well, it's equal to 400. That's how much they got me. That's how much they gave me, the perimeter. Yes, you're right, it's the perimeter, but specifically, I know that that perimeter has to be 400 because that's how much stuff I have to work with. So, what is the question mark? Well, I guess what I could do is I could just say two question marks is equal to 400 minus 2x. And I could divide both sides by 2, and I've got question mark is equal to 200 minus x, and that would be my thing. 200 minus X. Let me just go grab my cloth real quick. Grabbing right now. Here we go. Don't fall. What happened here? Oh, all right. So the question mark is equal to 200X. Or 200 minus X. 200 minus X. We cool? Alright, good. Symbolically represent the area. Well, the area would be this times this, so it would be x times 200 minus x. Alright, there we go. Area. And I put a parentheses x because that's saying area as a function of x. The area as it depends on whatever x value you give me. Does that make sense? All right, here's another question. Is there a domain problem? The question I'm asking here is X allowed to be any number it wants? Or is there a restriction on which numbers X can be? Well, if you think about it, can X be 500 feet long? No. No, because you only have 400 feet of fencing. How are you going to make a rectangle with 400 feet if it's 500 feet long? In fact, can X be 200 feet long? I would say no either. No, because if this were 200 feet and that were 200 feet, that would mean the thickness would have to be, you would use up all the 400 foot of fencing just to make these two lines and you would have no thickness. It would be like having your garden be 0 feet thick but 200 feet long, then you can't plant jack in that. So I would say that the domain of X has to be domain. And this kind of gives you an idea as to what the domain is all about. The domain has to be between 0 and 200. And you know what? I usually put the less than or equal to. But I would say it's actually, X has to be bigger than 0, and it has to be straight up smaller than 200. I mean, you can have X be really, really small. You can have like a 1-inch garden by almost 200. Whatever. All right. Graph this thing. Well, if we graph this, we notice that this would be a, what is this, 200X minus X squared. This looks to me like a negative parabola, and it, you know, it's doing this funky thing over here. So if we were to graph that, I would say, well, to be honest with you, I would say that the area is equal to zero at x equals zero, right? If I were to graph the area versus x, and at 200, the area comes back to zero, right? Because if I plug in 200 in here, I have 200 minus 200, which is zero, times 200, but 200 times zero is still zero. And then I would say that it's, if it's a parabola going up and getting big and then coming back down, I would say it looks something like that. Well, maybe a little bit more uniform than that. How's about that? Are we happy with that? This top point right here should be evenly right in between this 200 and whatever. Cool. This is the next part. I graphed it. So here's the thing about parabolas and solving these quadratic equations. Say that you would want to make the biggest area you could possibly make. What is the biggest area you could possibly make? And what I realize is maybe they didn't tell us. I think question E and F are asking the same thing. But anyway, what is the biggest area you can possibly make? Well, you can see that it actually peaks at some point over here. And I would say that's where x equals, well, it's got to be between 200 and 0, so it'd be 100. Because at x equals 100, this thing peaks out over here. So let's figure that out. 100 times 100 is... 100 times 100 is 1 with 4 zeros after that. That makes 10,000. It's 10,000 square feet. That's how big you're dealing with there. Cool? Everyone happy? All right, so let's assume that F is asking pretty much the same thing. I can tell you actually why there's a difference. It's because E was actually saying, I think what E was saying is, let's not assume that the perimeter is 400 for now. Let's just assume that perimeter is P. And if that were the case, then this 200 would really just be P over 2. And then you would figure it out from there. And then they ask you to plug in specifically the number 400 for P, and then you would end up getting the same answer that I got. Did I just lose you there, or are we cool? Now, what I'm going to do is I can use the graph. They're saying using the graph, approximate with the dimensions of an area using in 8,000 feet are. Well, here's what you need to do. You need to draw an accurate graph. After you get an accurate graph, find out where 8,000 feet is. And then you would say, okay, well, x would have to equal to whatever that value is and whatever that value is. Because it's actually, there's two places where y equals 8,000 on this graph. And so your x values, I don't know. Your guess is really as good as mine. I would say maybe at 80 and 120. You would just have to graph it out. I don't know the exact answer. You have to draw a much nicer picture than I do. Use a symbolic representation of A to get your answer in G. I actually would rather do that because I didn't draw out a nice pretty graph. So I'm going to erase this graph if that's all right with you. And I'm going to say, all right, well, if I want A to equal 8,000, 8,000 equals 200x minus x squared, I'm going to take everything, I'm going to throw them over to the other side. So I have x squared minus 200x plus 8,000. If you're lost, let me know, but I'm just going to keep going. Wait, do you have to find the answer for G? Oh, yeah. Like I said, I think what G is asking is they're asking you to approximate it. They're asking you to kind of guess to see what it is. And then in H, they're asking you to calculate it. Now, calculating it will be the super accurate answer. But then what's nice about doing G is that it will give you the here's my guess answer. And if your guess kind of matches up with the super accurate answer, then you're on the right track. That's really why they need to do that. Which is always good practice to do. Anyway, how did you solve this one? Well, in order to solve this one, you would use that trusty quadratic equation that I've shown you multiple times already. And you would say, okay, so it's positive 200 plus or minus the square root of 200 squared. So that's what, like 4,000 minus 4 times 1 times 8,000, all divided by 2. Is anyone confused as to what I did? Come on, this is one of the few times where I'm going to actually pause and say, do you get it? Are you on board? Take this opportunity now, process this. We cool? Come on, say something, please. Awesome, okay. Where did I get the 4,000? That's actually 40,000. And that comes from the quadratic equation is negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. In this case, a is 1, b is negative 200, and c is 8,000. So 40,000 comes from 200 squared. Does that make sense, Galen? Okay, awesome. Good. All right, I'm going to erase this, and I'm just going to say whatever the answer is you get. I don't know. I mean, you can calculate that out in your calculator. I'm not going to, I'm showing you how to set up this problem, so I'm not going to show you how to plug things in your calculator. Some people say the most appealing to the eye dimensions are those where rectangles have an approximate base of 1.6 times the height. Oh, okay, interesting. What are the dimensions of an eye-appealing rectangle that you can build using 400 feet of material? That is a very interesting question. What they're referring to is this thing called the Godin ratio. And psychologically, it is built into your brain that rectangles that are of this kind of deal, where this is, if this were x, then this is 1.6 times x. So if this were 1 foot, then this would be 1.6 feet. If you look at what I think is really interesting is if you look at pictures, the ratios that they're set to is this ratio. It's called the Godin ratio. It has something to do with this thing called the Fibonacci sequence. And there's this whole lesson on math that I can get into that I'd be really interested in going into, but I don't have the time to. But anyway, if they want this to be x and this to be 1.6x, then I suppose that if you want to solve for, what is it? What are the dimensions? Oh, if you want to solve for what x is, if this were the case, then I would do this. I would say that the area, no, wait, not the area. I would say that I wouldn't want the perimeter, if this is x, and I want to figure out the perimeter, I know that 2 times x plus 1.6x times 2 as well is equal to 400. I think what I would do is I would simply, oh, I'm sorry, you can't really see that, can you? 2x plus 2 times 1.6x is equal to 400. Then I would simply solve for x. Okay, fine, that's not that bad. Hey, what's 2 times 1.6? Anyone? That would be 3.2, I think. So it's 2x plus 3.2x equals 400. And so I would have 5.2x equals 400. And then I would have x equals 400 over 5.2. You guys can use your calculator. What is 400 divided by 5.2? 76.92. 76.92. I apologize if I'm coming off the screen. 76.92. So if x is equal to 76.92, what is this bottom part? Well, that is 200 minus 76.92. Anyone got that answer? What is 200 minus 76.92? Use your calculators quickly. By quickly, I mean now. All right, there we go, 123. And I'm just curious to know at this point is, what is 76.92 times 1.6? Try that. Multiply this by 1.6 and tell me what you get. Did you guys do it? I can't tell. What is 76.92 times 1.6? And I don't have any more time to ask you the same question, so I'm going to move on to the next problem. Oh, hey, you get the same answer. Awesome. That's a great deal, because that's actually exactly the parameters that we want to set up. Moving on. Erasing. Ready? 1, 2, 3, go.